you are a steed. Harlan, it's Genevieve. Listen, I understand your feelings. I really do. But this is no time for sentimentality. If Origin is uncovered, every single one of us will burn for it. It's time we buried the dead, don't you think? Next message from Genevieve Aristide. Harlan, it's me again. If you want an apology, then I apologize. I was wrong. You were right. In any case, I want to be sympathetic, but the situation is urgent. I'm sending Mapes to take care of things since you seem reluctant to do what needs to be done. I hope you can find it in yourself to assist him. End of messages.
Pretty. Enter the vault.
We've got our styles.
Yes, sir.
Here, something.
Contact.
Oh, fuck.
Blew me down the stairs. How you doing, buddy? Oh my god, he's bleeding.
You have to destroy this facility before he lets her out. There are four pylons. Damage the reactor cells and you'll trigger a chain reaction. Blow the whole place to hell, where it belongs. If he lets Alma out, you have to stop him.
Locate Dick fucking. Oh no. Yeah, I love this. We're gonna have some head crabs coming up top.
We may be out of contact from here on. Be careful of this Wade guy. God only knows what he's capable of.
It's nice and dark. What the fuck is this? I've seen some shit, but not a giant mechanical eyeball. Actually, I've played Terraria before, so never mind. Hey, I saw you guys. He ain't creeping me out. Good, we're back. Why do
you
I have
still
a...
don't know, do you? What you are. Why? What's the first thing you remember? What's your given name? Where were you born? You have no history. You and I were born from the same mother. You must have sensed it She cannot see in your mind, but perhaps you can see into hers. A life of waking from one nightmare, only to find herself deep in another. I will set her free.
Fuck you. No. Wait, why do I have a pistol only? Something's not right here. Guns at.
System analysis commencing.
And what's with the big mechanical eyeball?
They want to destroy her, but I think she's suffered enough.
Let me in!
We put her in there 2 days before her 8th birthday.
Error. No life signs detected.
What? She died 6 days after we pulled the plug.
Sequence complete.
This is how it ends.
Oh my goodness. Why? What the fuck? Look, it's not my fault. Don't blame me. I was birthed from you. Well, now Wade's dead. So is Alice. And everybody else. Excuse me. Excuse me, Mother. I'm quite hungry. I didn't know if, maybe we could, go out to eat or something? I don't know. I'm hungry. Think maybe we could grab a bite to eat? This again? Come at ya, you fucks. I am the great mighty Pooh, and I'm going to throw my shit at you. A huge supply of tish comes from my chocolate starfish. How about some scotch, you little twat? Things have gotten, like, really fucking weird. pylons, I'm assuming. Sorry about that. God. Time to go. Not that way. I have to fight the sphincter people? You think maybe I could, you know, like not fight them for once, but... Do you really think you'll survive in here? You don't seem to know which creek you're in. Sweet corn is the only thing that makes it through my rear. How do you think I keep this lovely grin? Wait, where did Sunshine go? Or no, we're coming out the other side? Where are we? Because this isn't where Ding Dong was. Interesting. Guess he's dead. Remember the rest of the lyrics. Something getting rather mad. You're like a niggly tickly shitty little tag nut. When I knock you out with all my... Oh, fuck it.
He's alive. I just picked up his signal. If you can hear me, get to high ground. A chopper is standing by.
Oh, really? Yeah, I've heard that one before.
This time we mean it!
Oh yeah, I've heard that one before too. Actually, not really.
Oh, I am the great mighty Pooh, and I'm going to throw my shit at you. A huge play of tish, come from my chocolate surface. How about some sketchy little twat? Oh shit. Dun, 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 dun.
Oh, the sphincter people! Space sphincters. Woo! The surface, why didn't we bust a window and leave? got that song stuck in my head, apparently. Dun 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 dun. I guess that's the place exploding below, or no, it's actually where I'm supposed to go. Great. Oh good, into the depths. It's fucking black. You don't have to bring this creepy stuff on me. Nah. Just keep singing poop song and I'll be perfectly fine. Okay.
I've tried to forget.
Yeah.
I've tried so hard to forget.
To forget what? Honey bumpkin. Hello? I didn't mean to shoot you, honey. I'm sorry. That's my mother. We've seen this before, or something like this, didn't we? Yeah. Only without fully nude mom. Ouch! Fuck, I was actually killed! Boom. 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 Boom, boom, boom. Boom. You don't seem to know it's kick you're in. Sweet corn is the only thing that makes it through my rear.
I've tried to forget.
How do you think I
I've tried this so hard to forget? You were born here, in this place. I was there.
No, no, no. No, no, no. Excuse me. Yes, my baby. Okay, I will, but please. Don't whisper.
You will be a god among men. Take her back to the vault.
Alma Wade? Wait, so if I'm your son, then why the fuck are you making it so creepy for me? Why not just love me? I will help you. I will do everything in my power to kill you. I mean, to free you from your pain. I'm coming back to you. Don't take it out on me. Take it out on Wade. Oh, he's already dead. Oh my god. The outside world. I think the place is exploding. Holy fuck! Oh my god! Move! Move! Oh fuck! What the hell?
We still don't know the extent of the damage.
We haven't been able to get through to anyone since the explosion. What about Alma? What happened to her? What was that sound?
It's over? What? Oh my god, what the fuck is going on? It can't be over! Now I want to go and play the next one. Or I guess we gotta do the DLC first. What the hell? Okay, well, that was F.E.A.R. I'm not exactly sure what to think. Because honestly, I don't know what the fuck is going on. Okay, well, F.E.A.R., I guess it's a first-person shooter game with, you know, action elements. It's just got a small element of horror to it. Very creepy, very unsettling. It's very dark at times. The music sets the mood. It's mostly jump scares. The only portion where there's actually a threat by creepy things is when those floating guys come out of the space sphincters at the near end of the game there, I guess. Other than that, everything seems to be very scripted, and it's mostly just gun battles back and forth. Segments of gun battles, a segment of creepiness. Segment of gun battle, a segment of being with your squad and then immediately being separated every fucking time. Or getting to a helicopter and watching it explode. So I have no idea what to think about the story. Because I don't understand. I mean, at first, you know, it was a little bit difficult to understand. I kind of understand more. So Alma was the girl. The little girl, I think, right? Maybe? Or something? And that's Alma Wade. So she was part of the Wade family, along with Alice, whatever her name was, and Ding Dong Wade, the Hitler Wade. And so Alma gave birth to me, the prototype, and someone else, another one, and took me away from her, and then they shut the whole thing down. She died. She started to haunt everything, but why did she have to haunt me? Why did it have to be so creepy for me? So we went and we killed that one guy, the Paxton guy, and then we found Alice dead, almost already dead, and then she grew up into a mature, naked boob lady. And that one guy died, the main Wade, the Hitler Wade. There was a big mechanical eyeball. We blew up the entire facility. There was like a massive fucking nuclear explosion or something. I don't know what the hell happened there. At first, I was like, holy shit, is the entire city imploding on itself? Because I thought, you know, with the facility underground, I thought the explosion was happening in the distance and we were watching the city like go into this big sinkhole. But no, it was a massive explosion. And holy crap, that was awesome. Seeing the pieces of wood flying. Oh, jeez. And I couldn't move. I was trying to get over to the building to take cover, but apparently we survived. But it's obviously not over because she grabbed onto the helicopter or whatever she is. I don't understand. There's so many little holes here and there that I need filled in order to fully understand it. So I'm sure playing the DLC and the rest of the games would probably fill most of that in. I'd say so many things that are different that I don't understand. I really, really like the gameplay. As I explained in my upcoming Let's Play video, it felt very Half-Life-y, where it doesn't tell you where to go or what to do, so you find yourself wandering around a little bit, finding small hidden areas and pathways to take, opening doors, using things like valves and stuff like that, finding hidden stuff. And in here we had health upgrades and what was the other kind of upgrade? The little green one for your slow-mo thing. Those were really cool to find for permanent upgrades. I like that. The gunfights were really, really fun. I've got to say, I absolutely loved the gunfights. The gunplay was very smooth. It was very, very fast-paced sometimes. I loved the effects in this game. There were little destruction, the way the sparks would blow off the metal and hit the ground and bounce for a couple feet. Or how when you shoot your shotgun, you see each individual shell fly off, and then when it hits, you see like the dust particles blow off from each bullet that hits or shell or whatever, or little ball. I mean, I guess because it's a shell that explodes into a million different pieces or something. I don't know. I guess it depends. No actual Delta Force operatives were harmed in this production. Oh God, it's not over. That was just a little bit of thing I was doing there to add some tension onto it. So I am the first prototype. So I'm some superhuman, basically, I guess. Like I said, the gunplay, I loved it. Enemies would die fairly. They didn't do unfair damage. Sure, I was only playing on moderate difficulty. Everything seemed to go really, really well. Everything was working properly. I'd have to say the combat system was very, very good for a game for 2005. You know, where usually a first-person shooter like this would be nice and clunky. Like, for example, the combat in Half-Life is okay, but it's very, very clunky these days when you look back on it. You know, and while apparently the AI in Half-Life was very good for the time, honestly, I don't know how anybody could say it's got good AI these days, because it doesn't. It has terrible AI. AI pathing is terrible, and as for some of the creatures, I mean, they're pretty straightforward, but back then I'm sure it was pretty good. The AI in this game, in my opinion, sometimes outdo what you see in modern-day games that are coming out present-day. You know, they run around, they jump through windows to take cover, they will flip tables over to take cover, push cabinets out to take cover behind, and none of it's scripted, or none of it seems to be scripted. You know, they talk to each other, they give each other commands. That kind of stuff is really, really cool. I love to see that. And they gave me the same vibe as the military from Half-Life, where, you know, you keep hearing their radio comms, and, you know, sir, here's something. You know, that's the exact same thing I keep getting every time I hear them talk. or lob a grenade. And I like how they say we gotta flush him out and they throw a grenade to get me to run away, you know, or get out of cover because they're throwing a grenade. That's really cool. They didn't overuse grenades and they weren't pinpoint accurate. That was good. I liked grenades in the game. They were very nice, very balanced, and they were sometimes hard to come by, and I didn't use them too often, but I used them enough. But there was a lot more action than actual creepy elements, which I guess I was kind of expecting, but I did scream a few times in the game, so I can't put it off. It's not a full-fledged horror-only horror survival game like some of the other games I've got that I picked up, so it's going to be really interesting when we get around to those. Not sure what I'm going to be doing next. Obviously, for the F.E.A.R. franchise, I'm definitely going to be moving on to the F.E.A.R. 1 DLC, of which there are two different DLCs to play through. I don't have the... Do I? No, I don't have the card with me right now, so I can't see exactly what they are. But you'll see them. There'll be a separate standalone Let's Play. Might even be an episode long, depending on how short they are. I don't know. We'll see. So you'll have to keep an eye open for that if you're interested in watching more F.E.A.R. Or if you're interested in watching me play more horror games, I am going to be moving on to some P.E.A.R. horror games. P.E.A.R. just full-on horror games soon. Probably going to do a DLC for this and then move on to something else that's more horror-based. I don't know. We'll see. But for right now, guys, I'd have to say F.E.A.R. was definitely a fun game, surprisingly. And I suck at horror games because I'm way easily scared. But I was very surprised that I really enjoyed this game. It was really fun. No wonder it's got very positive ratings on Steam. If you end up getting a few dollars and it goes on sale, I'd recommend picking it up purely for the gameplay. And the story seems like it could really be a good, fun story. I just need to learn more in order to be fully into it, since I don't understand much of it. There were no over-the-top soundtrack moments, unfortunately. There were creepy soundtrack moments, like you hear playing now on the menu. But thinking back, there is no memorable soundtrack that I can remember. You know, like, I can think of The Witcher 3 right now, and there are so many awesome soundtracks in that I can remember. And I'm just using that as a basis. Like, you know, Half-Life didn't really have too much of a soundtrack in it. It was more of an ambience that it used in the game, or an ambiance. You know, so... But in a game like this, especially with a massive explosion at the end, which was a great climax, by the way, I think that there should have been some over-the-top dramatic music playing, like the Terminator theme or something. I don't know. Either way, guys, thanks so much for watching, and I actually cannot wait to play the next F.E.A.R. game. As much as I am fearful of what might happen and what might scare me, I am still really looking forward to playing more of this series. I'm assuming the first game's DLC are going to use the same engine, so it's going to look very similar and feel very similar. We will see. I'm not sure if it's going to be like the Half-Life style, where they add in new weapons and a nice mini-story that takes place in a different character's eyes, or if it's going to pick up where it left off, or I don't know. We shall see. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next F.E.A.R. Let's Play, or whatever Let's Play you get around to watching.